In this video, we will talk about factors affecting drug absorption, a topic from pharmacokinetics. Let's get started. Absorption is the movement of a substance from its site of administration into circulation. For example, if the drug is given by oral route, as shown here, absorption would be the process of moving the drug from the lumen of the gastrointestinal tract into the blood circulation. And if the drug is given by intramuscular route, absorption is the movement of the drug from that muscle into the circulation. With that thing clear, now let's see the factors affecting this absorption. These are the aqueous solubility of the drug, the concentration of the drug, the area of the absorbing surface, and blood flow at the absorbing surface. Let's go into the details of each one now. First, the aqueous solubility of the drug. See, the medium of our body's internal environment is water. And the drug given in the solid form cannot enter this in its intact form. It must dissolve in the aqueous biophase to become available for absorption. This occurs in two steps. First, disintegration, which is the breaking down of solid dosage form into fine particles. And second, dissolution, which is, well, the dissolution of active drug molecules from fine particles into the solution. After this, the drug can cross the biological membrane and thus get absorbed. So basically, disintegration and dissolution determine the aqueous solubility, which in turn determines the rate of absorption. Now, different formulations start from different steps in this process, and therefore have different rates of absorption. In tablets and capsules, the drugs are in solid form. They have to go through both disintegration and dissolution in our body, which takes time. So the absorption from them is slow. In powders and suspensions, the drug is already in the form of fine particles. They don't need to disintegrate any further and can directly undergo dissolution. Therefore, absorption from them is relatively faster. Finally, in solutions, the drug is already dissolved. So it's ready to get absorbed right from the beginning. And therefore, it shows the fastest absorption among all these. Thus, the faster the drug gets dissolved, the faster the absorption. The next factor is the concentration of the drug. Passive diffusion depends on the concentration gradient. For example, in the first figure, we have given a dilute solution in which the concentration of the drug is low. So the gradient from outside to inside is small. Whereas in the second figure, we have given a more concentrated solution. So the gradient is large. Because of the difference in the concentration gradient, the absorption from the dilute solution is slow. Whereas that from a concentrated solution is faster. In simple language, we can also say that absorption from concentrated solution is faster, simply because more drug is there to be absorbed. So this was about concentration. The next factor is the area of the absorbing surface. Obviously, the smaller the surface area, the less the drug is absorbed. And the larger the surface area, the more the drug is absorbed. For example, the stomach has a smaller surface area as compared to the intestine. This is one of the reasons why absorption from the stomach is slower than that from the intestine. So this was about the surface area of the absorbing surface. Next, blood flow at the absorbing surface. See, as the drug is absorbed, the blood flowing through the local blood vessels removes it from the site of absorption. This maintains the concentration gradient for the absorption of more drugs. So the rate of absorption depends on local blood flow also. Let's see how exactly the absorption is affected in case of less blood flow and high blood flow. If the blood flow is slow, the drug won't get cleared fast enough. So absorption of the remaining drug would be delayed. Or in simple words, the absorption would be slow. On the other hand, when blood flow is fast or more, the drug is cleared quickly. So the remaining drug enters faster. Or in simple words, the absorption would be faster. So basically, the more the blood flow, the faster the absorption. So these were all the factors. Please note that these are the general factors that apply to all routes. Apart from them, there can also be other factors, depending on the route of administration. But we will cover them in a separate video. As a quick recap of general factors, the drug is absorbed faster when it gets dissolved faster, is given as a concentrated solution. The area of the absorbing surface is larger, and blood flow at the absorbing surface is high. That's it for this video. You can find notes and explore our entire animation video library on our website. The links are in the description. If you liked this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.